is true that as the biometric tests increase in our quest to bring the procedure to a higher accuracy level, they have become a necessary adjunct to assessing the patient prior to the procedure, as well, in a lot of cases, assessing the postoperative management of patients who had LASIK. So I think that most of these diagnostics have become a prerequisite for a LASIK. They have in our practice. We, for many years now, cannot evaluate properly a refractive surgery patient without an epithelial, corneal epithelial map. Biometry, adaptive optics, wavefront topography, in many ways, tomography, reflection topography, are now intricate parts of evaluating refractive surgery patients besides the clinical refraction. And I think that although they may add a little bit more time and hardship in the pre-op and sometimes post-op evaluation, they definitely raise the bar as far as the accuracy and the documentation of what we're doing with the procedure. When there's a large number of diagnostic tests performed, there might be some conflict between two individual tests, and then the clinician is compelled to bring in a judgment of which one of the two or whether some of them will be repeated. I think it's crucial, as the spectrum of cornea diagnostics and whole eye diagnostics increase, to create an awareness of what each one of these modalities really represents and what the advantages and disadvantages of which one of each one has. So we have worked a lot in trying to educate surgeons in regard to the pros and cons of each technology, and also trying to bring technologies that are not necessarily engaged in a specific platform in order to independently confirm some of the findings and measurements that we make. Indeed, the more testing performed, the more labor is involved for both the diagnostic and clinical team and patients alike. And the cost, both in hours used as well as financial costs are certainly a concern. But I think when it comes down to safety and efficacy of LASIK, these are always built into the procedure's success. And I think it's imperative when the technology is available to make it possible and available to each patient that's encountered.